Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the Ferrari 360 Modena. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. I've got a back catalogue of about 180 videos featuring a Maserati Gran Turismo, a crazy Mercedes CL65 with a V12 engine, and this beautiful Ferrari 360 Modena. Be great to have you as a subscriber. So in this episode, we are going to talk about the absolutely fascinating subject of immobilizers. Now stick with me here, because immobilizers are a bit of the bane of the life of owners of certain Ferraris, including the 550, the 575, the 355, and the 360, all of which have a very similar immobilizer system, which causes a lot of grief for most drivers. So in this video, I'm going to try and explain how these systems work, but also a few tips and tricks for how to use them on a daily basis. So let's get going. So when these cars left the factory, they were provided with two keys and three immobilizer remotes. They also came with a secret PIN code, which was the code that was required to unlock the immobilizer module on each car. Now that code was sealed in a paper envelope. I don't know if you remember, anybody who's old enough, but I remember when you used to get your codes for your credit cards and things like that, they used to come in a little paper envelope and you used to tear the strips off the outside, and inside there would be the number. Now, every car came with one of those codes. So over the years, people have lost those codes and they have no record of the number. Now, when I bought this car, all it came with was one key and one remote. So it was missing a spare key and it was also missing two of the remotes. The dealer where I got the car from was very kind and offered to provide a new key, which I have in my pocket here, which is a very nice new style key, which is very nice, thank you. But obviously they weren't able to provide the new remotes. So fortunately there's a guy in Australia here called ImmoFix, and I'll provide a link in the description down below, because I'm sure his service will be of invaluable use to lots of owners of these kind of cars with this immobilizer system. He provides a service whereby you send off your immobilizer module to him and he will decode the original PIN code from the module and also supply new remotes. So the first step in doing this service, obviously, is to get the immobilizer module out. So we're going to put the car in the garage and we're going to turn the battery off. Then we're going to remove the immobilizer module and we're going to send it off to our guy in Canberra to get the code extracted and to get our new remote controls. And here's a bit of video showing how that is done. Basically, it requires you to unscrew a panel of carpeting behind the passenger seat here, and once you've got into that area where all the modules are located, there's a metal plate which holds the module, but unfortunately it's round the back, so you have to kind of pivot up that metal plate in order to remove the immobilizer from behind. Then there are three plugs that you have to disconnect on the immobilizer and three bolts that have to be undone to remove the immobilizer from that plate. So once that was all done, I sent off the immobilizer to ImmoFix, and within a week, the immobilizer was back with the PIN code revealed and three new remotes, two black style remotes and one red master remote. So once I put the immobilizer back in the car, the new remotes, which look absolutely identical to the factory ones, now will operate the car, which is fantastic. So when you go to unlock this car, if you leave it unlocked for more than about 90 seconds, I think, it will automatically arm the immobilizer again, so you can't start the car. Now, when I first got this car, I thought what you had to do was to actually physically lock the car again and unlock it again in order to disarm the immobilizer. But in fact, you don't have to do that. All you have to do is to hit the immobilizer button once and that will disarm it again so you can start it. So you don't have to go through that whole process of physically locking the car and unlocking it again. Just a single press on the immobiliser button will unlock the immobiliser, allowing you to start the car. So that's a really useful trick to know, so that you don't have to go through that whole long lock and unlock process. Now, the other thing about this car, which I mentioned in my last video, is that not only did it have the factory immobiliser, which is this one here, but it also had this one here, which is a non-factory immobiliser. And I've since discovered that in Sydney, in the past, not so much now, but in the past, many insurance companies required you to have two separate immobilisers, which is absolutely insane anyway. So this one is made by a company called Mongoose, and that one also has to be disarmed before the car will start. And similarly, I only had one of those remotes and I didn't have the PIN code. So in order to be really sure that we've got a full set of spares that can operate this car in the event that one set gets lost, I was able to get some spare remotes for this Mongoose system. Unfortunately, they're not made anymore, but you can get them off eBay, which is great. So I got a couple of those remotes, and then the challenge was to code them to the system. And that was a very complex process, requiring you to stand on your head and recite the VIN backwards three times or something like that. No, I'm kidding. But what you did have to do is turn the ignition on and off a number of times to put it in learning mode, then press the arm button on the new remotes, and that codes them to the system. And I finally got that to work this morning with some help from a very kind gentleman called Bruce at Mongoose in Brisbane. So if you're watching, thanks, Bruce. We've got those remotes coded. So now finally, I have two full sets of keys, a set that I will use and a spare set to keep at home in the safe, so that if the worst happens and I lost my keys for any reason, I would still be able to access the car, drive it, and disarm the immobilisers. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did like it, don't forget to smash that like. It'd be great to have you as a subscriber. Hit that notification bell, of course. You can follow me on Instagram down here, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.